Alright everyone, it's I, Schroeder Jester Valentine, and my monitoring phone is being wonky with live streams again. I don't know. It's just old. It's just old like my PC is. That's the problem. I just have no modern equipment. That's my real issue. That's my real issue. But anyway, yeah, it's I, Schroeder Jester Valentine. And, today, we are going to be continuing on with, Deltarune. Now, last time, of course, first up, we managed to befriend the Resistance. Oh, wait, that was a few streams ago. But, yeah, also, what's going on? There we go. God damn it. Okay, so last time we managed to, not only find Noelle, but we also, of course, defeated Birdly twice. And after the second time we defeated Birdly, he, finally broke down and told us the truth that he is actually pretty average. He's not the super genius that everyone thinks he is, you know, like, he's actually a really just normal guy. And, I kinda expected that to happen. Not gonna lie, like, that is one of the old shorts of the book. But even then, you know, like, he is still pretty useful and does want to help us find Noelle. However, soon after we did rescue Noelle, she was captured once again by Queen, and is now being apparently basically turned into her personal servant. We also, of course, met, Spamton, who Spamton actually seems to know a whole hell of a lot more than he's letting on when it comes to this, this whole Knight and Black Fountain shit. Like, he knows a whole lot more, than is going on. That's pretty obvious. And, yeah, what else did we do? Well, we also, of course, we also got captured by Queen, and Ralse was very nearly turned to a butler until we, of course, managed to, one, escape, and two, of course, find him. He was being attacked by a whole bunch of birds. And, you know, managed to rescue him. And that brings us to where we are now, after, listening to the, facts from those, radio guys about Queen and how she basically went insane the instant the Dark Fountain appeared, and how it's all connected to this Knight guy, like the, last one was. So, yeah, in other words, there seems to be something about these Dark Fountains that is sending people insane, in other words. It all has to do with that one guy. So, it makes me wonder, what is, like, the connection here? Like, what... To which, honestly, right now, I think we're gonna need more clarification, like, Chapter 3 and Chapter 4, because, yeah, that isn't really elaborated on here, unfortunately, but, you know. So, anywho, let's actually get into this. Let's actually do this here. Ah, shit. Well, Hey, Axel, how you doing? Hey, sorry, I was a little focused here. Huh? Hell yeah! So this is my favorite character in Deltarune, that would have to be main character, holy shit! But yeah, as I was saying, favorite main character would be Ralsei. Ralsei, he's a little goat boy. So of course he's, very cool. And he's my fave for the mains. For non-main characters, like for enemies and stuff, Task Manager without a doubt. And as for normal enemies, I got a few. Well, it had to be the tasks, because the tasks are like, they're fucking awesome. The second would have to be the swatches, because, oh my god. And yeah, like the swatches are just so... like, I don't know, I just love them. And then... Now, least favorites, I'm not so sure, but... Alright, so you got defend. Defend. Alright, you know what? Oh, God damn it! Alright, now then. There we go. Spanton boss fight. Eventually, yes. Oh my god. Of course it involves a giant super robot. Now then. All right, so of course not. I think of you as a friend. Yeah, no. Yeah, it works. Alright. There we go. Ah, God. All right, now then. In case of extreme awesomeness. Okay, I just had to say that. That was just simply unavoidable. And what the fuck is going on with my... Because that's the thing. Desktop streaming servers are fine. But my monitoring phone keeps freaking out. I feel the same. Don't get any ideas. I mean it strictly as friends. Oh yeah, and just so you know, tomorrow I will not be beginning my second playthrough yet. Second playthrough of both chapters 1 and 2, because I am not very satisfied with the scuffed quality of the first Deltarune stream. It was very scuffed only because I had to quit halfway through because it started storming. So yeah, I'm not very satisfied with that. And number 2, I missed a lot of secrets. I missed the Jevil thing. I missed a whole lot of stuff. And that's what I tend to do when I do playthroughs. Is I tend to go through all the main shit first. And spend entire time going through all the main stuff. And then, later on, I will go back through and do all the side stuff that I didn't do in my first playthrough. And that's what I do. And most of the time it works, but you know. Yeah, a lot more. Yeah, I know. It's nice that Ralph says Ralph say. But tomorrow, probably I are gonna check out a VR chat map, or I'm gonna continue with my Honkai playthrough. Oh my God! Oh, it's fucking song. It's so good. Oh my God, that's the machine we created in the first part! I am so scared. Nah, it's not that scary. I mean, it's a duck. Thank you. Ha ha! We did. Oh, wait. Shut this, you uppeth! I love Ruxels. So much, the guys. Hilarious. Goddess! Damn it! Don't worry, we'll come back for you. Death. So there's another new named character, Death. Wonder who he is. It's a castle. Thank you. Ferris wheel. I don't believe that for a second. Yeah. Say something cool. Alright, yeah. And here begins the Susie Noelle romance. you gotta love Burley's meme face as he flies in. I fucking love this game. Ah, man, this second playthrough is gonna be... It's probably gonna be even better because by then I'll like have my PC upgraded. Probably? Question mark. I always promise PC upgrades and never actually fucking do them though, because I don't have money. So, yeah. Yeah. I gotta figure out what's up with my phone, too. There's a lot of tech stuff I always have to figure out because my equipment's old as shit and it's slowly falling apart, but... Alright, enough ranting. Let's focus on the game. Holy shit! Da 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 la 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 tra la 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 la. Sorry, I just remember the last time. Wearer wires, psycho wires, more like it. And you can tell it's a really, really high level enemy because it does the same fucking attack every time. And now, we're gonna save. And then... Well, first up, we're gonna buy some shit. I just love them. All of the characters are so good. All right. Back. Hmm. Alright, so one of them's already good. Personally, it feels like we got lucky on that one. Shit! Those are really fancy statues. Chainmail! Oh my god, I get the joke. There we go, now we got everyone's armor upgraded and everything there figured out. And best of all, they cordoned up those cars, so we don't have to, Chat! Hey, Joey, how you doing? I am now on my way to the Spamton boss fight. Always trying to get there. But he's a big shot! Yes, Azrael, the way more successful one. The big breadwinner. That Azrael. Alright. Hi, then shit, I got hit again. Oh god damn it. Da 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 da. Oh, he's not here. We'll get him next time. It's kind of a disappointment, though. Hey, that's Susie. Yep, that's Noelle's room. And then there's, yep. Yep. Wonder what kind of clothes she found in there. Why is my phone being so weird? Hell yeah. No. Thank you. Alright. The battlefield was electric. Overclocked high heels, hell yeah! What does that smell like, serval? Alright. Alright, then, now then, what do we do next? Because by God, I am making out it's alive. It's too late to die now. You sound like me back when I had that really shit modem. Ah, shit. The power of love and friendship! That's so anime, I fucking love it. And what is up with my phone? Oh my god. The mobile servers for YouTube are shit. Like, the PC servers are so great, yet they could not figure out the mobile servers. It makes monitoring my streams hell. Because I use a phone to monitor my streams to make sure shit doesn't go wrong, because I do not trust this PC with my life. So, and the fact that they cannot figure out proper mobile servers makes doing that a nightmare. So, yeah. But, anywho, this is my shorter day. So I don't think we'll complete the full. Boss fight today. But goddamn, we beat her and we're only level 2 because I have been like... And what's more is that instead of the love system, it uses the traditional leveling system because the thing about Deltarune is that unlike Undertale, where pacifism is the key, Deltarune is a lot more combat focused. Granted, I take the pacifist route most of the time, but sometimes there are certain enemies where you have to fight them. Good example is Spamton. Another good example is some of the swatches. Sometimes it is impossible to fully, peacefully negotiate with swatches because sometimes they are an absolute pain. Now, I am debating where or not. I mean, this is my shorter day, so. I am debating where or not we can do the big super robot thing today. Let's see. Yeah, I realized. If that battle gets very intense, Guess what I'm playing? Remember the song Bullet Dance or Bullet World? Remember that song? Yep. Because, you know what I decided? Yeah, we're ready. We're ready for this fight! And hang on, I need to get this Honkai Star Rail. Yes, I know, that's why I'm playing Honkai Star Rail tomorrow. It's because 1.1 is out. You don't need to remind me, Epic Games Launcher. Yep. So see, it all has to do with that night guy. That night guy is the main one who is like creating all these dark worlds. And in that case, the entire Earth would be destroyed. Oh, determination! Determined enough! That's more like it! I've noticed the giant freaking robot in the middle of the palace, though. What the fuck? Alright, it's not time for BlazBlue music yet. Not yet, but I do have it up. Hell yeah! Yeah, it's time, baby! Yeah! Maid! No, it's actually Schrodinger's giant big ass duck robot. Haha! His name is Thrash! Haha! Do you think you have defeated us? No. All right, but seriously. Thank you. Ha ha! Damn it. Hey, I'm gonna go get a drink. And this time the boys' blue music is going away. This time it's for real. All right. I'm gonna beat the shit out of Santa Death Parade there, but first, I'm gonna need more healing stuff. then. Only then will it be. And this time I'm gonna play the Blaze Blue music the entire fucking fight. Okay, like, I will not turn it off. Yep. Not so great. Yeah, I took note. I think we passed by it when we went on third floor, and I immediately took note. That's why I mentioned the whole, you know, super robot thing. Like, a while ago.
Mm-hmm.
There's my Mamba Forever body armor. Hell yeah. And that's what I was trying to get working. But now it's working. This song just spits mecha fights. I don't think so. Hi now. Da 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 da. Yeah, fuck this. I don't think we'll be able to beat her today. Because... Oh, we might be able to. Fuck yeah. Oh, will she beat us? Nah, she won't. Funny how when I'm being, you know, like, super cool dude, like, unserious, like, just crazy town, woohoo pizza, you know, blaze blue blasting mode, I can't do shit. But all of a sudden, I go super serious like this, and I can do it perfectly. What the fuck? Makes no sense. You don't remember Ralsei? Yeah, there was a third guy. Chat! Don't do it, Noelle! You know, she does make a fair point. Right. Yep. Yeah, if they choose to violently destroy this, then the entire fucking world will be destroyed. Yeah. I love how last time it was Bert. I love how now everyone's shitting on Birdly. It's fantastic. It's me All right. Alright then. Yep. Gets me every fucking time. All right, then. Now then. No. Yeah, we should go check on Lancer. Knew losing him back there, yeah. Yep. Nice. Hey, look at those trophies. Suck it, Azrael. I love. I love ironically dunking on Azrael with this room. Hell yeah! Task. Emphasis on the ass, manager. Okay, that was a little too, I have feelings for task manager, okay? She's like this game's serval for me. And the real serval will return tomorrow on Honkai Star Rail because tomorrow I will be playing more Honkai Star Rail. Because they finally released the new MSQ, so I can't actually play. But then again, I mentioned that like several times throughout the stream. Alright, I guess it's one last stop before we go. And finish this. What we have so far, this masterpiece of a game. Remember, this game is still unfinished. And the new chapter is not coming out until sometime. It's hard to tell with release dates with Toby. Because the team he has working on these games is pretty small, so so, and new. Shit. Yeah, I do have a bit of a theory, because... Nah, that'd be too dark, though. I don't think. Yeah. Plus, there's still a lot of unanswered questions, so... This is not necessarily the best ending, though. Yeah, this wasn't the best ending. However, next time I play, I will try to get the better ending. But the thing is that in a round two, aka, you know, second playthrough, won't be happening for a little while. Because, tomorrow, so, you know what, I'll explain it in the end. All right. Yep. Yeah, we, Fuck yeah. Huh? Alright. I kind of chuckled a little at that joke. Ah, this game's so good. It's Chris. Doing. Yeah, sure. Yeah. All right. Yep. Invasion of the Cat Pairs. What? You know what? Not gonna ask. Yeah, it's been a crazy day, but... Yeah. But there's the whole issue of... there's the whole issue of, you know, potential world collapse and a whole bunch of other nasty shit happening that you would definitely not want to happen. So it does seem like a good thought, but overall there are some very key issues. Yep. It sounds like the saying for our next adventure, though. Yep. So, all right, we can see that these are a bit darker than they seem. Oh, fuck. Oh my God. Holy shit. Oh boy. Goddamn. Holy shit. All right. Goddamn. The ending was quite something. So, what do you think about Chapter 2? Chapter 2, they really raised the bar. Honestly, the whole. So, what they like? Well, now let's do my normal format. Story-wise, Chapter 2 was very good too. Like, but it was actually better than Chapter 1 because number one, a lot more of the number one, the way they handled Noelle was very good. And a lot of the characters were very, very fun. I like them all. I love them all a lot. Especially Task Manager. Task Manager, oh man. And also the main boss, the main villain, very enjoyable for this chapter compared to the last main villain. You see, the last main villain didn't do a whole hell of a lot. You know, like he barely did anything. Like except to stand there all looming, like, and you know, barely even had dialogue. Whereas here, she's just given, oh my God, just tons of just dialogue, and it's absolutely awesome, and she's absolutely awesome. Funny as hell. Very, very enjoyable. I loved her through to the end. And she also had great character design, which was also a big plus with Queen. Her character design was fantastic. There are a lot of reasons to love her. What do you think about it? And also, the enemies had a lot more depth to them as well. Like, you know, they weren't these, I feel like the original Deltarune Chapter 1 had a bit of an issue where a lot of its enemies were just, you know, your standard stuff. And not a lot of them were really fleshed out as well as Chapter 2. Yeah, that is the main issue. And also, another big thing in how they. Now, it really changed the story for the better in Chapter 2 is that, you know, instead of having, you know, your classic, instead of having, you know, the, you have to absolutely defeat him and he's still a piece of shit, even after you defeat him sort of thing with the original. Here in Chapter 2, you know, Queen eventually is like, ah, shit, you know, after hearing the truth of the matter, she's like, ah, shit, you know what? If this continues, then yeah, it will be bad for everyone, and it has a change of heart, kind of like Asgore. You know, she's more like Asgore in that way, and that is a very, very good. You know, we need more Asgores, less Chapter One kings. You know, more Asgores, less Chaos kings. That's what I'm gonna say. Now, what didn't. And also, you know, a lot of the cyber puns, a lot of the characters, they were all wonderful. They were all fucking fantastic. You know, and it also does pick up very nicely from the last chapter, you know, showing how Chris had his knife embedded in the pie, because last time, you know, he basically was like, you know what? No. No, I'm not gonna submit to the player's control, and I'm gonna go down there and I'm gonna eat that fucking pie, even if it means ripping the player, you know, the thing that the player used to control me out, and doing it myself. I'm gonna eat that pie. And that's just what he did. And that I think is wonderful. You know how Chris can, you know, kind of act for his own sometimes, and sometimes he has the feeling where, you know what, no, I don't have to obey. I could do this myself. I could eat the pie even if they tell me to go to bed. You know that shit's awesome. Now, and also I do like how they elaborated a lot more on the night guy is. You know, how these fountains, they're all being created by someone. By someone sat through the earth and then, you know, drilling them out. And it seems that based on the ending, this night guy is doing it through Chris. So it makes me wonder, how did Chris get all the way to the computer lab, you know, and then do it there? Like it's pretty obvious that Chris is partly responsible for these fountains, and also the one who seals them away when he's not being controlled by Knight. So that's pretty interesting. I think they need to elaborate a bit more on that in Chapter 3, but at least we are getting some answers. You know, at least we are getting some, you know, very basic answers. Characters are a lot more likable in Chapter 2. And very memorable. Spamton, especially. Spamton, I am... Unfortunately, we did not get to do his boss fight. Next time, on our second playthrough, we will do his boss fight. That is an absolute given. I will absolutely do his boss fight, no matter what. Ruxles is still just as fucking... I love him. Like, a lot of these characters I just fucking love. Does that mean that I love him as much as ones in Undertale? Of course not. Undertale is the classic. It's the OG, you know. I like Undertale's characters a lot more. Even though, you know, Deltarune is better and everything else. Gameplay-wise, oh my god. It's very wonderful gameplay-wise. Not only do you have, you know, your traditional RPG fights, but you also have the mecha fights, and the mecha fights are fucking... I love mecha anime, I love Gundam, I love that kind of shit, and that just got me, that just immediately got me. You know, as somebody who absolutely just fanboys over mecha, this is game for me. Now, there were some things that I did not like. Birdly's fights were way too hard, for one thing. His first fight was way too fucking hard, and I do think that did need to be toned down a bit, but other than that, we're pretty much alright. What else? Level design in this game was a lot better than the first. The first already had very good level design, but this took it to a whole new level. I think that it was way better than, even Chapter 1. And I do think that when the game is, like, polished, when everything is finished, they are gonna have to, like, you know, rework the style to kinda fit all the chapters, and I'm not sure how that is gonna work exactly, but I don't doubt they could do it. You know, I don't doubt they can. I don't doubt they couldn't. They can do it. I think they can. But damn, this game was fantastic. Overall, with Chapter 1 and Chapter 2 included, it takes it up to 9.8. The story right now is really, really fantastic. Pretty much everything's fantastic, except for, like, I mean, there are a few things here and there. I mean, it does have the Undertale issue with some of its boss fights where they are way too fucking hard. But, you know, overall, it's very good. So, yeah, that's pretty much it for this stream. Very fantastic game. Love it to death. You know, all that stuff, so. But, yeah, so tomorrow, I will not be starting my second playthrough of Deltarune. Instead, I am going to focus on playing more Honkai Star Rail because the new MSQ just dropped. And because the new MSQ just dropped, you know, I can't really, you know, I gotta focus on that. I gotta focus on getting back into the Honkai groove and doing more Honkai stuff because that's kind of become a staple of my channel, is Honkai. So, yeah, I'm gonna do a lot more Honkai tomorrow. But on Friday, that's... That's what I'll probably consider starting Deltarune Chapter 2 if I do not do more Honkai stuff. Or rather, no, not Chapter 2, but my second playthrough of Deltarune if I do not do more Honkai stuff. And by second playthrough, I mean I am going to go back through Chapters 1 and 2 together because, you know, like, I want to do all the secrets throughout, you know, and see how much better I do. So, yeah. Now, I mean, my schedule's pretty stacked. I still gotta do the Undertale pacifist shit. I still gotta do Honkai, as I just mentioned. I still gotta do, like, tons of stuff. So, I got a pretty packed schedule for the next few weeks, at least. So, in other words, lots of content, lots of shit's gonna get done. You're gonna see it all. Oh, yeah, June 17th. I might not stream on June 17th because that is actually my birthday. So, yeah, I might not be, I might or might not stream then. It all depends on where I feel like it, I guess. But anywho, I gotta get going. Can't stay here forever, you know the drill. So thank you all for watching this wonderful stream here. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day, night, week, whatever. And I'll see you all tomorrow for Honkai Star Rail, where we'll be picking up right where we left off in the MSQ when I complete all of it. So, yeah. Good night, everyone. Stay classy, everyone, and good night. And I'll see you all tomorrow for Honkai Star Rail, with it being literally the first Honkai stream in about 2 weeks. So, yeah, see you then, everyone.